Hello and welcome to Integrated Medical Biochemistry with Dr. Bijoya Chatterjee. Today we shall talk about mass spectrometry principle and its applications. So what exactly is mass spectrometry should be our first obvious question. So mass spectrometry, abbreviated as MS, is an analytical chemistry technique which helps to identify the amount and types of chemicals present in a sample by measuring the mass to charge ratio. So what exactly is the procedure of doing this? So first, organic molecules are bombarded with electrons. These electrons are converted into highly positively charged ions. The charged ions break the parent molecular ions into small daughter ions. The formed ions are separated by deflection in magnetic field according to their mass and charge ratios. The mass spectrum of each compound so obtained is unique and it acts as a chemical fingerprint to characterize the compound. So basically, mass spectrometry is a technique which gives us a chemical fingerprint of a molecule. Just like we have DNA fingerprinting, we have chemical fingerprinting, and mass spectrometry is the technique which does it. Now, the equipment that we use to carry out the mass spectrometric analysis is known as mass spectrometer, and a mass spectrometer generates multiple ions from the sample under investigation. So the sample can be anything. It can be serum, urine, fluid. So this is then separated according to specific mass to charge ratio, represented as M by Z. So what is this? This is a mass to charge ratio, and then records the relative abundance of each ion type. So a mass spectrometer is able to find out the concentration of different types of ions that it has generated and their concentration, which is known as relative abundance. So there are different types of mass spectrometers based on the type of mass analyzers used. They are magnetic deflection mass spectrometer, abbreviated as MDMS, electrostatic mass spectrometer, abbreviated as EMS, time of flight mass spectrometer, abbreviated as TOFMS, and quadruple mass spectrometer, abbreviated as QMS. So these are the different mass spectrometers that are available. So let us look at the components of a mass spectrometer. This is a schematic diagram of a mass spectrometer which has the following six parts, which we will see. The first one is the sample inlet. The second part is the ionization source. The third part is a mass analyzer. The fourth part is the ion detection system. The fifth one is a vacuum system, and the sixth one is the data system, which generates the mass spectrum for the sample. Now, the different ionization methods are needed to convert the sample into ions. So first, there is a sample inlet through which the sample is introduced, and the sample stored in large reservoir from which molecules reach the ionization chamber, and at low pressure it's in steady stream by a pinhole called molecular leak. So from here the sample is introduced. Then the ionization is carried out. The atoms are ionized by knocking one or more electrons off to give it a positive charge by bombardment with a stream of electrons. So most of the positive ions formed will carry the plus one charge. So the ionization can be carried out by electron ionization MS, chemical ionization mass spectrometry and desorption technique, which is also abbreviated as FAB. So this is the way to carry out ionization. So now classification of ion sources. So how is the ionization process occurring? Now the ionization can be done by desorption sources. So these are the sources for it, that is electrospray ionization, matrix assisted laser desorption ionization, fast atom bombardment method, field desorption method, and plasma desorption method. These are the desorption sources. Then comes the atmospheric pressure ionization, which is can be carried out by two procedures. One is the atmospheric pressure chemical ionization and the other is the atmospheric pressure photoionization. Then the third way of doing the ionization is the gas phase source, where there is electron impact ionization, chemical ionization, and field ionization. And then there is detection by different mass analyzers. So these are the different analyzers which will analyze the spectrum. So they are magnetic sector analyzer, abbreviated as MSA, which has high resolution and it calculates the exact mass. A quadruple analyzer, which is abbreviated as Q, it has low resolution but it is quick and cheap. Then there is time of flight analyzer, abbreviated as TOF, and it has high throughput. It has ion trap mass analyzer, QSTAR, which has very good resolution, and or it is an all-in-one mass analyzer which has all the components in it. And then there is the ion cyclotron resonance, abbreviated as FTICR, which has high resolution. Calculates the exact mass and it is very expensive. Then there is the double focusing analyzer. So these are different types of mass analyzers. So once the whole process ends, each molecule will have its spectrum produced on the computer. So now, what is that spectrum? What is a mass spectrum? So mass spectrum is a sorted collection of masses of all the charged molecular fragments produced. The relative abundance of each of the characteristics is the characteristics of the compound. The mass spectrum can give detailed information about the composition of an organic compound and the position of functional groups. And it also can be used for the determination of molecular weight. So this is the mass spectrum, which is basically the chemical fingerprinting of a compound. So it is also abbreviated as MS-MS or MS-square. So it is technique where two or more mass analyzers are coupled together, which we saw in the diagram. The first mass spectrometer separates big peptides based on their mass, which is called the parent ion. The parent ion enters the collision cell for the second mass, MS, and then the ions collide with argon gas molecules and are broken into smaller ions. These daughter ions are detected and quantified by their mass spectrum in the second instrument. The high selectivity of MS square is that the parent ion mass and daughter ion mass are used for characterization. So the application of MS-MS includes identification and quantification of proteins, drugs, screening, pesticides and pollutants, and screening of inborn errors of metabolism, example, organic acid ureas. So this is a comparison between the generalized mass spectrometry and the tandem mass spectrometry, which you can just take a look at, where in mass spectrometry there is single mass analyzer, and in tandem mass spectrometry there are two mass analyzers, and that is why it is known as tandem, because two mass spectrometers are used, and the the spectrum that it gives is a combination of both the spectrometers. So now the applications of mass spectrometry are in the fields of proteomics, genomics, drug discovery, clinical testing, and lipidomics. So in proteomics, we can find out various sequences of biopolymers such as proteins, oligosaccharides. We can determine the molecular mass of peptides, proteins, and oligonucleotides. We can determine protein structure, function, folding, and their interactions. We can identify a protein from the mass of its peptide fragment. We can detect post-translational modifications in complex biological mixtures, and we can monitor enzyme reactions, chemical modifications, and protein digestion. So this is the application in proteomics. We can also use it in genomics to sequence oligonucleotides. We can do drug discovery by determining structure of drugs and metabolites and screen the metabolites in biological systems. We can also carry out clinical testing, perform forensic analysis, and detect disease biomarkers. This technique can be used in lipidomics to compare the lipidome between control and test groups and identify various abnormalities in biological systems or different lipid profiling in different biological conditions. The limitations of mass spectrometry are equally important to know. So it is difficult with non-volatile compounds, needs pure compounds for comparison. A mass spectrometer cannot distinguish between isomers of a compound. Mass spectrometers cannot distinguish between optical isomers. It cannot distinguish between the ortho, meta, and para substituents of aromatic compounds. Combining MS with other separating processes such as high performance liquid chromatography and gas chromatography can minimize many of its limitations and makes it an ideal technique. So let us take a look at two of them. So what exactly is LC-MS? Now, combining the two analytical methods reduces experimental errors and improves accuracy. So the combined technique between MS and HPLC is known as LC-MS, and this combined technique helps in reducing the shortcomings of MS and LC individually. So LC has become the standard for assay of steroid hormones for diagnosis of endocrine disorders. Normal liquid chromatography or immunoassays cannot differentiate between D2 and D3, which LC-MS is able to do very easily. Now, what is GC-MS? GC-MS is the combined technique between MS and that is mass spectrometry and gas chromatography, and it is known as GC-MS. The application of GC-MS includes drug detection, identification of unknown samples, and it has been regarded as the gold standard for forensic substance identification. So this is how some of the shortcomings of MS are overcome by combining it with chromatography. So to summarize the whole process of mass spectrometry, it begins with introducing the sample into the ionization chamber. Now the source of ion is through these various sources, which we have already discussed. After being ionized, it enters into the mass analyzer where ions are separated. So these are the different types of mass analyzers which we have discussed. And after the different ions are separated, they are sent for detection to the detector. And these are the three different types of detectors, that is the electron multiplier, multi-channel plate, or the Faraday cup. Once the ions are detected, the signals are sent to the data system, and the data system is now able to generate a mass spectrum. Now this mass spectrum for individual ions present in a molecule. which is acts like a fingerprint. So thank you for watching, like, share and subscribe, and do not forget to hit the bell icon.